Hello and welcome back. How can we use the dateAdd function to manipulate dates, for example, in a text box? So what can we do with the dateAdd function? We can add years, months, quarters, weeks, days, hours, minutes, seconds. Not only add, we can also subtract. That means we can have dateAdd function calculate the date in future as well as a date in the past. So let's see how this is done using VBA. Go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and you see here I have created here a user form. So we'll go to view and view the object, and here I have two text boxes, text box 1 and text box 2, and when I click the command button, it should execute this line of code where I'm adding days. I'm adding 2 days to the date in the text box. Therefore, you can also see that the dateAdd function returns a variant date, and it takes 3 arguments. The first argument is the interval, that means it can be D for day, M for month, Y for year, Q for quarter, H for hours, N for minutes, and S for seconds, and so on. I'm going to show you that link also where you can see how these intervals are to be placed and in which format. Then you have what is known as a number. That means, do you want 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, and then finally you need a date. So we will place the date in our text box 1. So let's run this now, and we are going to add dates. So I run here, and let's say I write 31st Jan 2020, and if I click here, it should give us 2 days, which is February 20. Once more, so if I write here 19th January, click here, it gives me 21st January. I close this now. I'll double click here. I'll comment this out, and let us say I want to add 2 months. So I'll run this. We'll have 31st March 2020, and we are going to add 2 months to that, so it will give us 31st May 2020. Close this, and in a similar pattern we can remark this out, and we can add, let us say, 5 years to the date that will be in the text box 1, and the other date will be displayed in the text box 2. So here I'm going to write 11 March 2020, click on the command button, and we get 5 years from now the date that we wish to get. Now, let me show you the link to the website where you can study this carefully. So you can go to this website where you have the dateAdd function, you have the syntax, and as I said, dateAdd takes 3 arguments, the interval, that is days, months, years, minutes, seconds, the number, that is 2 months, 3 months, 10 hours, whatever you wish to add to the date, and the date placed somewhere. You can hardwire it or you can place it in a text box. I'm just going to scroll through to show you the different settings. For example, for year we have the Y. For the quarter we have Q, M for the month, N for the minute, not M but N. Please note that. And then you have some samples here, which you can try out. I hope you found this interesting and useful, and if you did, please like And if you would like to subscribe to my channel, please feel free to do so to get the latest videos that I post. Thanks for watching.